Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Reading from Canto 9, Chapter 19, King Ayati Achieves Liberation, verses 27 and 28.
Sandana.
Sandana Mandaya means Rajayani Go Mukla Show Sattai Sattais.
Sasanivasam Suridam. Prapayam iva gacchatam vigyayeshvara tantranam maya virachitam prabaho sasanivasam suridam prapayam iva gacchatam Vigyayeshvara Tantranam Maya Virachitam Prabaho Sasanivasam Suridham Papayamiva Gacchatam Vigyayeshvara Tantranam Maya Virachitam Prabaho Sa, Devayani, Sanivasam, living in the association, Suridam, of friends and relatives, Prapayam, in a place where water is supplied, Iva, like, Gacchatam, of tourists on a program. We're going from one place to another. Vigyaya, understanding.
Ishvara-tantranam.
Under the influence of
the rigid laws of nature.
Maya virachitam.
The laws enforced by Maya.
The illusionary energy.
Prabhu,
of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Sarvatra.
In this material world.
Sangham.
Association.
Usrishya.
Giving up.
Swapna apamyaya.
By the analogy of a dream.
Bhargavi.
Devyani.
The daughter of
Sukacharya.
Krishne.
Unto Lord Krishna.
Mana.
Complete attention.
Samanivesya.
Fixing.
Yadunat.
Gave up.
Lingam.
The gross and subtle bodies.
Atmanaha.
Of the soul.
Translation.
Thereafter, Devyani, the daughter of Sukracharya, understood that materialistic association of husband, friends, and relatives is like the association in a hotel full of tourists. The relationship of society, friendship, and love are created by Maya of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, exactly as in a dream. But by the grace of Krishna, Devyani gave up her imaginary position in the material world. Completely fixing her mind upon Krishna, she achieved liberation from the gross and subtle bodies. Srila Prabhupada, you want to do translation?
Yes.
Yeah, go ahead.
Anuvad. Tatpashchat Shukracharya ki putri Devyani samajh gayi ki pati mitron tatha sambandhiyon ka sansarik saath प्याऊ में यात्रियों की संगति के समान है। भगवान की माया से समाज के संबंध, मित्रता तथा प्रेम ठीक स्वप्न की ही बाकी उत्पन्न होते हैं। कृष्ण के अनुग्रह से देवयानी ने भौतिक जगत की अपनी काल्पनिक स्थिति छोड़ दी। उसने अपने मन को पूरी तरह कृष्ण में स्थिर कर दिया और स्थूल तथा सूक्ष्म शरीरों से मोक्ष प्राप्त कर लिया।
One should be convinced that he is spirit, soul, part and parcel of the Supreme Brahman, Krishna. But somehow or other, one has become entrapped by the material coverings of the gross and subtle bodies consisting of earth, water, fire, air, ether, mind, intelligence, and false ego. One should know that the association of society, friendship, love, nationalism, religion, and so on are nothing but creations of Maya. One's only business is to become Krishna conscious and render service unto Krishna as extensively as possible for a living being. In this way, one is liberated from material bondage. By the grace of Krishna, Devyani attained this state through the instructions of her husband.
कि वह परब्रह्म कृष्ण का अंश दिव्य आत्मा है किंतु न जाने किस तरह वह पृथ्वी जल धरती वायु आकाश मन पृथ्वी तथा अहंकार से रचित स्थूल तथा सूक्ष्म शरीर के भौतिक आवरण में बंदी हो गया है। मनुष्य को जान लेना चाहिए कि समाज का साथ मित्रता प्रेम राष्ट्रीयता धर्म आदि माया की सृष्टियां हैं। मनुष्य का एकमात्र व्यापार कृष्ण भक्त बनना और यथासंभव कृष्ण की अधिक अधिक सेवा करना है। इस तरह मनुष्य भवबंधन से छूटता है। कृष्ण के अनुग्रह से देवयानी को यह स्थिति अपने पति के उपदेशों से प्राप्त हुई।
ओम ज्ञान तिमिरंदस्या गिराजना सलाकाया चक्षु उन्मिलितम येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimakti Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gaudavani Pacharine Nirvisesa Sunyavari Pasyatya De Satarine Panchakalpa Turuvishya Kripa Sindhu Behebhacha Patitanam Bhavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namaho Namaha Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivasadi Gaur Bhaktivinoda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur sings, Maya Ravase, Kacho Base, Kacho Ha Bubu Duvai, Chief Krishna Dase, Vishwase, Kalida Adukanai. He's explaining that this is the nature of the material world. And it's mentioned here. Oh, I'm sorry. It's mentioned here also in the same principle that in this material world, Karanam guna sanga so sadasad joni jambasu. The living entity is never in one place, always moving from place to place, life after life after life. Due to the desire of the living entity, he's placed in a position to fulfill that desire, even in the lowest species of life, or in the middle planetary system, such as the Earth planet, or in the realm of the devas, the realm of Svargaloka. So, just like Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains, just like on an ocean, there are sometimes straws floating in the ocean waves. And these straws are being tossed from one place to another by the churning of the waves. And sometimes two straws come together by the arrangement of the ocean, and a few minutes later they're separated by that same ocean. So by the time factor, the conditioned soul is thrown into a material situation. We get a set of relatives, friends, and others. And the conditioned soul is thinking, this is my life. These are my relatives, these are my support for all my desires in this world. But here, who are these friends, relatives, and other people we meet? Just other souls who are also being thrown by the waves of material energy. Because we have similar desires, we're put together by a certain set of living entities. Or even sometimes, one who is my friend in the last life becomes my enemy in the next life. One becomes my enemy in a previous life, now is my friend in this life. And one is my enemy in my last life becomes my real enemy in this life. So we call those relatives. When I speak to devotees about their struggles in Krishna consciousness, their biggest problem is their relatives. My mother doesn't want me to be a Hare Krishna. My father is an atheist. So much trouble, difficulties coming not from outside, but from the closest people in our life. You want to be a brahmachari? Oh, that's a problem. No wife. The relatives, the parents think, where's the grandchildren? Yeah, my mother used to become upset with me. No grandchildren. Krishna's better. Fortunately, I have a sister who got married, so my mother was a little pacified. Now that's the way in the material world, you want to be Krishna consciousness, so many restrictions, so many blocks. There was one brahmachari, he joined a temple in Chaupati many years ago. His mother was really upset. So after being there for some time, the mother came to the temple. She threatened her son, come back or I'll commit suicide. And everybody, she was making a big show in front of all the brahmacharis. That if you don't come back, I'll take my finger and I'll push it in this light socket and I'll commit suicide. So everybody got worried. So the boy went back home. But after staying home for a little while, he came back to the ashram again. And then after some time, the mother came again. Part two of the drama.
Drama part two.
So again, she made her threats. But nobody listened this time. She was making a show. And so there's a saying that goes on in both in Christianity and also in our tradition. The most difficult place to practice spiritual life is near your own hometown. Yeah, because everyone sees you the way that you were when you were growing up and nothing changes for them. No, Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains. What is that verse? Can't think of the verse. Manaso deho geho yokichumur arpi lutu abade nanda kishwar. And my home, my wife, my relative, everything, it's yours, Krishna Nanda Kishwar. Everything belongs to you. No, everything in this world is simply the dance of the material energy. And it's compared to a jailhouse. Jail. We were talking about prison preaching in jail. No, the scriptures compare this place, it's called Martyaloka, the place of death. And it says everyone in this place is locked up by chains. It's like in some prisons when they have very violent prisoners inside. They don't give them any freedom in the jail. They lock them with chains. And so these chains restrict everything. So this world is also has its chains. The chains of sex life. There are iron chains, there are silver chains, and there are golden chains. So one might think, I have golden chains, and you have iron chains, I'm better than you. Somebody is thinking their sex life is very nice. And someone is thinking, I'm struggling. Another is to think I'm suffering. King Yayati, he thought sex life was everything. He made a big program just to try to enjoy in that way. But he came to his senses after some time. Because in the material world, nothing can give satisfaction. In the material world, the more you try to enjoy, the more you become dissatisfied. That is the nature of the material energy. There is some temporary relief from suffering when one engages in some kind of sense enjoyment. But that temporary relief is what it is. It's temporary. And then the pain comes back, but it comes back even stronger. Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada gives the example. If you just like you have a mosquito bite. So there's some pain, there's some itching there. So you want to relieve the pain, so you scratch it. So while you're scratching it, it seems to be getting better. As soon as you stop, it comes back even worse. So sex life is that, like that. It seems like you're relieving the pain of the feelings of lusty desires.
आप सोचते हो कि आप जो कामें चाहें उनका जो वेग है उनके कष्ट से आपको मुक्ति मिल रही है।
But after some time, it comes back even stronger. The same desires are stronger.
लेकिन कुछ देर बाद वही काम वासना और तीव्र वेग से आती है।
But if you don't scratch it,
लेकिन यदि आप उसे खुजलाते नहीं,
you simply tolerate it.
आप उस वेग को सहन करते हैं।
After some time, it goes away.
तो फिर कुछ समय बाद वो वेग अपने आप चला जाता है।
That's true with all material desires.
ये तथ्य सारी भौतिक इच्छाओं पे लागू होता है।
Especially sex life.
विशेष रूप से और जीवन में।
Just forget about it.
भूल जाइए उसे।
Maya will remind you.
Maya आपको याद दिलाती रहेगी।
Oh, you haven't enjoyed like you haven't used to enjoy in a long time. I'm still here to remind you what you're supposed to do.
तो माया में याद दिलाती रहेगी अरे आपको भोग करना है आप पहले कितना अच्छे से भोग करते थे अब मैं यहाँ पे फिर से हूँ आपको याद दिलाने के लिए कि आप आनंद लीजिए.
Hello, who's there? It's me, Maya.
इस तरह हमारे दरवाजे पे आवाज आएगी. कौन है? मैं हूँ माया.
Oh Maya, I'm busy today. Come back tomorrow.
लेकिन हमें कहना है मैं आज व्यस्त हूँ. आप कल आइए.
I'll be back.
ठीक है मैं आती हूँ.
Yes, it's me, Maya. You said come back tomorrow. I'm here.
फिर से अगले दिन खटखटाहट आएगी कि मैं हूँ माया. आपने कहा था कल आना तो मैं आ गई.
I said tomorrow. It's still today.
हमें कह रहे हैं मैंने कहा था कल आना आज है तो आज है ना कल आना.
So when Maya comes, if you tell her no, she won't listen. But if you tell her later, this is a good way to keep her away.
तो माया के लिए आप कहेंगे नहीं नहीं तो वो नहीं सुनेगी. लेकिन आप उसको टाल देंगे कल पे तो फिर ये उससे दूर रहने का अच्छा तरीका है.
So we have example here of King Hayati. He went to the limit.
तो हमारे यहाँ राजा हयाति का उदाहरण है.
And he couldn't even enjoy as a human being, so he became a goat. Because animals have more proclivities, more tendencies, more abilities for sex life. Prabhupada tells one story about one man. He was a leper. And there was one very nice prostitute in town, and he wanted to enjoy with the prostitute. Now he was married, he had a very nice wife also.
और उस जो कोड़ी व्यक्ति था उसकी पत्नी भी थी।
But he didn't have enough money because the prostitute was very expensive.
लेकिन उसके पास इतना धन नहीं था कि वो वेश्या के साथ भोग कर सके।
So his wife could understand his desire.
लेकिन उसकी पत्नी ने उसकी इच्छाओं को समझ लिया।
So she was thinking, I should go to the prostitute and do some seva for the prostitute. Maybe she'll accept my husband.
तो पत्नी ने सोचा कि मैं दर्शन के पास आती हूँ और उसकी सेवा करती हूँ ताकि वे मेरे पति का प्रस्ताव स्वीकार करें।
So she went, she met the prostitute, and she did some seva for the prostitute. Then she said, "My husband, he wants to come and be with you."
तो पत्नी गई वहाँ दर्शन के साथ रही और उसकी सेवा की और बाद में उसने बताया कि मेरे जो पति हैं वो आपके साथ भोग करना चाहते हैं।
Prostitute is thinking, such a nice wife. Why is he coming here?
So Darshan said that he itni achhi patni uske paas hai to fir wo yahan kyon aana chahte hain.
But she said, all right, send him.
Lekin usne kaha ki theek hai unko bheji.
So he's all excited. He's going.
Wo bahut hi zyada excited tha.
He's going to the prostitute.
Darshan ke paas jaane ke
liye. Now she's very intelligent.
Ye Vaishya bahut buddhiman thi.
And she wants to do something to discourage him. So she cooks a nice feast. And when he comes, she serves the feast in three different kinds of plates. She serves the same preparations in a leaf plate, in a silver plate, and in a golden plate. So this leper, he's looking, he's saying, she's serving the same preparations in three different plates. So he has to ask, why are you giving me the same food in three different plates? She looks at him and says, you have a nice wife, go home, it's all the same. It's all the same. Yeah, so that's the illusion of sex life. And Prabhupada used to say, people think, well, I have a nice soft bed and I have a nice beautiful arrangement for sex life, and the dog is doing it in the street, I'm better than the dog. Pleasure is the same. No different. Prabhupada illustrated that using a different example one time. I was personally there with Prabhupada for this one. This was interesting. This was in New York back in 1975, yeah. So we were on a morning walk with Srila
Prabhupada.
We were walking through Central Park in New York. It's a very big park, and there's also cars that drive through the park. There are roadways in the park. So the cars are going by. Very good. Perfect translation. And so, Prabhupada stopped the morning walk, he turned around, he looked at all the devotees and started to speak. He said, the man is running on four wheels and the dog is running on four legs, what's the difference? He asked us, what's the difference? Nobody could say anything. And Prabhupada said, no difference. The man is running for sense gratification, the dog is running for sense gratification, the business is the same. So this material world, sense gratification, as it says in the Bhagavad Gita, is simply a source of suffering, that's all. Sometimes devotees say, well, Krishna consciousness is sense gratification too. Yeah, but that is called sense satisfaction, not gratification. It's satisfying the soul. And the mind and the senses also become satisfied when the soul is satisfied. But that is not sense gratification, that is devotion. That is actually the nature of the soul's relationship with the Supreme. So Maya will make you think that there's some happiness out there. She has so many plans. And if she sees you very austere, performing austerities and making nice advancement, she'll come up with some really difficult attractions. She'll bring your old girlfriend back to have you haven't seen for 30 years. Your old boyfriend. Yeah, it happens. Indra gets jealous that this bhakta here is making so much progress, he's going to take my kingdom.
So Indra jo hai ishaara ho jata hai jab dekhte hain ki koi bahut zyada pragati kar raha hai to mera rajya halat mein aake sakinda
ban jata hai. It's like when Vishwamitra Muni was doing all great austerities, Indra became disturbed, so he sent Nainika.
Jaise Vishwamitra Muni tapasya kar rahe the to Indra usse pareshan ho gaya aur Indra ne tapasya band karne ke liye Nainika ko bhej
diya to break his austerity,
taki unki tapasya band ho jaye,
and he was successful.
Wo safal bhi ho gaye.
And then, of course, Vishwamitra Muni fell down, got married to Menaka, and then they had a child, which was the famous Sukuntala. That's the famous story in India, the life of Sukuntala. That was the daughter of Vishwamitra Muni and Menaka.
So, we know that Menaka and Vishwamitra Muni, from Sukuntala, which is a very famous story in India.
So Vishwamitra Muni thought, now I'm just a useless householder. I fell down. I'm getting out. I'm going to go back to my austerities. And if Indra tries it again, I have a plan.
So Vishwamitra Muni thought that I was stuck in this. I'm going to go back to my austerities.
I mean, Vishwamitra Muni used to sit in ice cold water in the winter time up to his neck and meditate. In the summertime, he would sit with seven fires all around. He'd sit in the middle of the hot sun. Tremendous austerities. But, you know, as soon as Menaka could come, he was finished. So after he fell down, he was thinking, not this second time. So Indra saw, he's trying again. He sent another society girl, her name was Rumba. These girls are very beautiful and they dance in the heavenly planets as entertainers. So she came, but this time he got angry. And he had performed the yoga process so perfectly that he shot fire out of his eyes, and she was a burnt pakora. Not edible. So, and as soon as he did that, again, he fell down. So attraction to Maya and aversion to Maya is both attraction to Maya.
तो माया से राग या माया से द्वेष वो दोनों ही जो हैं वो गलत मतलब हमारे लिए कष्ट
है. This sex desire, what is it? What is that energy?
ये द्वेष इच्छा है ये क्या है? कौन सी शक्ति है?
It's the actual nature of the soul's love for Krishna, which has been diverted away from Krishna towards the material energy. So nobody by their own power can be free from the effects of the illusionary energy, especially the attraction to the opposite sex. It's not possible by one's own efforts.
कोई भी अपनी शक्ति से इस जो भ्रामक शक्ति है उसके प्रभाव से बच नहीं सकता है. विशेष रूप से विपरीत लिंग के प्रति आकर्षण से अपनी शक्ति से बचना असंभव है.
Only by becoming attracted to Krishna, one can give up the attraction to Maya.
केवल तब जब हम कृष्ण के प्रति आकर्षित होते हैं तब माया के प्रति आकर्षण हो जाता
है. It says if you meditate on Krishna's eyebrows, and one can destroy all desires for sex life. Yeah, even Maya tried to attract Krishna. Yeah, they Narayan Rish. He sent that, what was her name? Urmila, to come and attract Narayan, Maya Narayan Rish. And she was the best. But as soon as she came, Narayan Rish, they created all of these other beautiful girls coming from their bodies. No, she couldn't do anything. So if you take shelter of Krishna only, there's only one way you can be free from the attraction of this material world, is you have to develop your love for Krishna. And how do you develop love for Krishna? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Read Srimad-Bhagavatam.
Srimad-Bhagavatam ka adhyayan kijiye.
And take Krishna Prasad.
Aur Krishna Prasad ka aaswadan kijiye.
And if you do this all the time, not just sometimes.
Aur yadi aap hamesha aisa karte rahenge, aisa nahi kabhi kabhi.
It's me, Maya. I'm busy, sorry, go away. Prabhupada tells a story. I mean, there's a story about the life of
Prabhupada.
So Prabhupada was in Delhi. He was giving a lecture to these important people in Delhi. They were just government ministers and other people from the government. So many of the Western disciples were also there with
Prabhupada.
So Prabhupada gave a very powerful talk. And he was finished, and then one of the ministers, he came up and he full dandavats at Prabhupada's feet, just like a humble, you know, brahmachari.
So ek mantri aaya aur ekdam Prabhupada ji ko puri tarah dandavat pranam kar diya jaise ek number brahmachari.
And the devotees were shocked.
Aur bhakta sab aashchar par gaye.
Wow, such an important person. He's so humble.
Are kitna mahatvapurna aadmi hai aur kitna vinamra hai.
So they came to Prabhupada after. Prabhupada, what is it about you that attracts people like that? Prabhupada said, I have no lust. And he walked away. He got in his car And a few devotees came in the car and they started driving back to Prabhupada's place. And the devotees were thinking, boy, Prabhupada has no lust. We have so much lust, you know. So Prabhupada could understand what they were thinking. So when they got to Prabhupada's place, Prabhupada got out of the car, he turned around, he looked back at the devotees, he said, it's not because I have no lust, it's because I have no time. Maya, I'm here, no time, sorry, come back. So if we stay busy in Krishna consciousness, then even if Maya comes, we have no time. As soon as you take some time off, Maya will invite you for vacation. And this is how we develop our attraction for Krishna. Stay busy in Krishna consciousness. No time for anything but Krishna. But I have my family. I have my friends. I have my job. I have my hobby. I need to do time for those things. Just remember Krishna. And do whatever you do as a service to Krishna. Even our ordinary material activities that we have responsibilities with, do it as a service to the Lord. What is that verse from the Bhagavad Gita? 9:27. Yat karoshi aranasi, yat jahosi tadasi, yat yatapasi tu konte, yat tatkurushu mara arpana. All that you do, all that you eat, all that you offer and sacrifice, all the things that you give away, Krishna says, do it for me. Do it as a service to me. So this verse is mostly for people who have responsibilities outside. In other words, the grihasthas. But for the brahmacharis, they have no time. When I was a brahmachari, the mantra was work hard now, enjoy later. But there was no later. So every time we wanted to talk about later, it was still now. We were waiting for later, but it never came. So that was the idea. And when we used to go to sleep at night, when you were going down to go to sleep, before you hit the pillow, you were asleep already. We were so tired. But it was good because we kept nicely engaged in Krishna consciousness. So, even if you have nothing to do, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. We can do that forever. It's like Haridas Thakur.
So, if we don't have any service, then we have our Krishna mantra.